Hello and welcome to Miniature Adventures. I'm Big Lee, and this week I want to look at landing the Wargames butterfly. Why do I play the games that I play and the periods that I play? So this week I'm back to answering subscribers' questions, and today's subject is a question from Martin Metzer. He wrote, I'm a Wargames butterfly. I flit from one Wargame era to another as interest and energy wax and wane. So I have lots of bits and pieces from all over and only one or two that I consider done. What attracts you to the eras you game in? Well, thank you very much for that question, Martin. It certainly gave me food for thought, and I hope I can try and give you a satisfactory answer. I did give a short version at the time. I'm going to try and expand on it. But you know what? I actually come to a conclusion, I think, that I'm not really sure why I play the periods that I play, but we'll come to that in a moment. And apologies if there's any random sounds, noises, aeroplanes, all sorts of things. It's hotter than Hades in here at the moment, and obviously every window in the house is open, so there's no keeping the noises out. So I'm afraid a little bit of background noise is going to be inevitable while I'm making videos in such hot temperatures. So as I just mentioned, my initial response in the comments at the time when Martin gave me that question was relatively brief. There were comments after all, but I knew that there was definitely room for a larger subject in there. Now, as part of Postie's Rejects, I play mostly what Stuart, okay, Postie, sets up from his collection. However, I do also collect and paint armies of my own, and I'm drawn to turning points in history. Now, like Martin, I have an eclectic collection featuring World War II, multiple theatres, three periods of ancient warfare, colonial theatres of war now, and even some fantasy. And in all multiple scales, from 6mm up to 28mm. So, you know, pretty butterfly-ish, like many wargamers, I imagine. But this necessarily brief response to the comments that I gave Martin doesn't give the whole picture, and I knew there was a fuller response video in the subject. So here it is. So like many of you out there, I am most definitely a Wargames butterfly. As you've probably already gathered, just like Martin, I collect many other periods, and just like many other Wargamers, I'm interested in pretty much any period of history, and I'll flip from one subject to another all the time. It is not very focused or academic, which is why I would probably make a terrible historian. But, you know, I know I'm not a historian. I'm an enthusiast. I'm a wargamer. And I'll play any period that is on offer and enjoy learning about it along the way. And this is handy because the majority of my gaming is done with Postie's Rejects in their Shed of War in Gravesend. Now, Stuart's collection is mind-bogglingly massive, multi-period, multi-scale. And only a fool would turn down the opportunity to play whatever is being put on offer in the Shed of War. And of course, we can bring our own games to the Shed occasionally as well. But the majority of the gaming that I do with other gamers is from Stuart's collections, whatever he puts on. And that means we flip from period to period, from one game to the next, because we don't meet on a regular basis like a club. We meet in an ad hoc sort of basis. It's like, you know, put the call out and whoever can attend. Which suits us all down at the grounds while we're the rejects. No club would take us. But it does mean that we get to play lots of different periods in lots of different scales, flitting from one to the other. But what about when I play solo? What is it that gets me excited? What makes me collect the stuff that I collect? So now we get to the crux of the question. What attracts me to the periods that I collect and play? The very short answer to that is I tend to pick periods that I think are turning points of history, where history literally hung in the balance. Now, you know, when I actually take that statement and look at my collection, I could say it's not exclusively the case, but on the whole, I think it is reflected in my collections. You know, I'm fascinated by the imponderable possibilities of what might have been and how the outcomes we got have shaped the world we live in. Now, in recent years, I've also begun to appreciate more and more the interconnectedness of history, how one set of events shapes the next and so on, until the ripples of conflicts that happened hundreds of years ago can still have political resonance and effect today. So in some ways that's sort of taken me away from that turning point in history in some of the subjects that I'm looking at. Colonial history, for instance, some of those wars that I've been looking at aren't necessarily turning points in history, but they're very interesting because they still have resonance today. And it's an area that I'm probably going to explore more in the years to come, because I find it very interesting. And at the end of the day, that's my main criteria. I go where I'm interested, and I'll flip from one subject to another, and if something raises its head and I go, I like that, I'll go and explore it. But the reality is, and to try and tone down things here, there are probably more years behind me than there are ahead. But while I still draw breath, I will continue to collect. And so there is huge potential for me to branch into new periods and explore much more history than I've done in the first 40 years of my gaming career. Now, my current collection merely reflects what I've got round to so far. So thank you again to Martin for the question. I hope that this short and probably wholly unsatisfactory video has given you some idea of what it is that motivates me, what inspires me to collect and play the periods that I play, but also perhaps to explain some of my butterfly behaviour because of the group that I belong to. So I hope that that answers the question, and thanks again for the question. So as usual, I'm going to throw this question out to you. What has motivated the periods you have collected, and what drives your favourite gaming experiences? Are you shallowly focused on the cult of military personalities, or are your motivations deeper than mine? As always, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below or over in my blog, Big Lee's Miniature Adventures. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, please like, subscribe and share. And if you want to keep up to date with weekly content from this channel, please tap the bell notification icon. So until next week, stay safe, keep gaming, and of course, keep rolling high.